The latest South African to put our country on the world stage is none other than Ofentse Pitse. She is the first black South African woman to conduct and own an all-black orchestra. Pitse features in the hit Netflix series Queen Charlotte alongside International Grammy Award singer Alicia Keys in an all-women of color ensemble. Ofentse was chosen to orchestrate and be part of the concept of the reimagined orchestral version of Keys' hit song, If I Ain't Got You, and our very own conductor joined us here in studio this morning. It's so great to see you, and we love to claim South Africans that are doing so well.
Correct. Thank you so much for having
me. Welcome back.
Thank you.
To the AM Report studio. So you were here, with Ayanda.
Correct.
It was April of last year.
Yes.
And there was no talk of Queen Charlotte. In fact, Queen Charlotte was not even in the works back then.
Correct.
Tell us about that journey.
So, I mean, you know, the Queen Charlotte talks actually started recently. I think it must have been December.
Wow.
Yeah, when they reached out to me, and then they told me that there's this international broadcasting channel that wants to do a remake of a song, but it was very NDA, so they didn't tell me much. And they were asking if I'm available to go to London in April, and I was like, okay, I think I'm available. And then a few days after that, Netflix Africa reached out, and they said they actually want me to reimagine Two-Face Adiba's African Queen, and we'll be featuring Psyche for South Africa, Nikita Kering for Kenya, as well as Faye for Nigeria. So both things were happening concurrently, and then a few days after that, I actually found out that the big one was actually Netflix Global wanting me to do Alicia Keys' If I Ain't Got You in London.
So listen, thank goodness you had time in your diary.
Thank goodness I moved things around.
Gosh.
Yes. Yeah.
I'm completely fangirling out at the moment. We are such a big fan of you here on the AM Report. What has this journey been like for you? And when you think back to when you started out, did you imagine that this is where it would take you?
Not at all, because when I started out, my idea or my fuel was to actually give the platform to the musicians, right? Because, I mean, you've seen a conductor has their back to the audience, right? You never see a conductor's face because the spotlight is always on the players and the choir. So I never thought that I would be the face now of this entire movement. So it really is mind-blowing. And I think also some things are meant to be, so maybe I'm the chosen one.
Yes. Listen, I couldn't agree more. And what a face to be in front of your orchestra, indeed. The pressure that I'm sure must come with working on the international stage for one, but then reimagining a song like I Ain't Got You by Alicia Keys, which on its has its, you know, it sort of has a life of its own.
So, you know, the reimagining was, the orchestration rather, was done by Bobby Jane Gardner, who is a phenomenal black female musician and arranger. So Alicia had the conversation with me, and she was like, I want to make it as comfortable as possible for you. How would you like this process to be as comfortable? I was like, I mean, you're Alicia Keys, just give me the score, right? I was like, just give me the music. And she was like, no, I want you actually to be part of this entire process. And I was just like, just make sure that the score is kick-ass.
Wow, which it is.
Yes, I mean, definitely.
If our viewers have watched Queen Charlotte, I mean, it's breathtaking in so many ways, but the music is definitely one of the highlights.
Definitely. Definitely. And also because of how intricate, I wish I could just show you the score. If we could all read scores, I would show you how intricate the scoring was of this song. And even the arranger was there with me during rehearsals. So there were some parts we would add, right, to just add a certain flair and a certain flavor. There were some things that are not written in the score that I was interpreting how to move, you know. Wow. And it was quite African because they were like, we've never seen a conductor do that. I was like, hey, South Africa.
Now, the queen, the older queen, not the younger queen,
Golda.
Queen Charlotte, Golda Rochevel. I mean, she, first of all, she touched this very...
She touched my Bateson, correct.
Amazing.
Yeah.
And you know, she's spoken so many times in these sort of media tour interviews around Queen Charlotte, but the Bridgerton franchise as a whole, and how it's opened up sort of this whole world that previously was not accessible to black women, but to black actors as well.
Yeah.
Do you feel the same?
Correct, because, you know, when I got this brief, right, I'm a fan of the Bridgerton franchise. I was just like, there's no way I'm doing, like, I'm going to say no to this, right? And then for me, it was very important to be full on about the representation. And that's why when we got into the rehearsal space and I saw 74 chairs, and I was like, okay, these chairs are going to be occupied by a woman of color. Mm-hmm. I knew that I had to make sure that this is not just, oh, they look pretty, so they can just get away with it. I had to make sure that they're actually as good as they look. So as a conductor, I had to now turn the volume a little bit up to ensure that it's actually a world-class presentation, right? But we don't get enough opportunities. Also in the classical music space, you don't see a lot of me. So that's why I happen to be the first and the youngest. You don't see a lot of me. So with what Shonda Land is doing with the Bridgerton story and the franchise, I think it's really important and phenomenal, because they really were about making sure that everyone is seen. Even with the music video, they were very intentional, even that with behind the scenes, it's a team of black women, the makeup artists, you know, the hair, the nails, the person who's doing my nails, they make sure that it's actually a woman of color.
And the issue of representation, I mean, you can see it, right? The whole Bridgerton series, but perhaps even more so the latest Queen Charlotte installment. The issue of how black women are portrayed, how black women and their hair is portrayed, the fact that we tie our hair up before we go to bed. And it's not something that is othering in any way. It's just, this is what we've been doing for thousands of years.
Correct.
And this is what we do in Queen Charlotte. There's no whitewashing of what goes into being a black woman. She's so deliberate, Shonda Land, about how that representation takes place. For you as a black woman in this space, I mean, you're doing for other black children what you perhaps arguably never had.
Correct. Because there was no... there was no other me. So I didn't have a president when I was growing up. All I had was Days of Our Lives, The Bold and the Beautiful.
Exactly.
You know what I mean? I didn't have someone who looked like me and I was like, ah, I want to be that. So for me, it was so important to not only be the conductor of this, but to ensure that in between takes, I mean, there were a lot of the musicians in between takes that were like, well, was I playing correctly? Was that? And I was like, yeah, believe in yourself. Like, you were good. And some of them, I was just helping them to hone in, because there's also that inferiority of, shucks, this is the first time we are here, so are we good enough? So even just the validation of, actually, for you to be here, you are good enough, and I'm not going to try to make you feel small or whatever. We all really work to be here, and this is so important for all of us. So it was very important for me to highlight that in all of the players, even off the camera, beyond just rehearsal, to be like, listen, well done, thank you so much for being here, because we don't even get that in the space that we're in. We don't get a well done.
And you're not good enough. You're the best at what you do.
Yes.
And that is why you were there. So with you watching Queen Charlotte now, which I'm sure you've done by now, what was that like watching it as a viewer? With the perspective that you have.
So I did not watch it until the song was done, right? Because I didn't, because the song was for episode 4, right?
Yes.
Then after episode 4 happened and the video came out and the song came out, I have a deeper understanding of the importance of me actually doing this project, right? And then what it represents to people who've been messaging me. I've been getting a lot of DMs from across the world of people saying, I just showed my daughter that there's a you. Thank you so much. And I'm like, shucks, but you're the CEO for like a big company. And it meant so much that my fullness was seen, because it wasn't just me waving a bass, and it was like me giving the best of myself. And carrying my ancestors on my back.
Carrying so many people with you.
So
what does it take for our viewers who are watching and who have children? Maybe there's some children at home who are watching and thinking, you know, music is in my blood. What does it take to stand where you're now standing?
Grit, resilience. You have to be a visionary. There's a lot of no's that you're going to get. I've had so many no's, right? And you have to also get mentors. So I believe that in order to be great, you have to believe in something that is greater than yourself. And before you shine, you have to polish. So I make sure that the people around me are actually the people that I aspire to be like. So they give me all the best advice. My conducting mentor is one of the best conductors in Africa and even in Europe. So just make sure that the people that are around you are the best people around you. And then just hard work. I know I make it look easy and I look good, right? It's hard work. Yo, I mean, that shot was like a full day shot of me just conducting, standing the whole day. Yeah. And you have to hold your position the whole day, because if you as a conductor want to sit down, the rest of the team, the energy is going to go down. So you have to understand that it's a lot of resilience, and the output may be just for 4 minutes, but it's like a 2 day shot that you have to ensure that you execute. There's a lot of things that go on behind the scenes. So just remember also why you want to start. Yeah. So for me, it's for Africa and the diaspora, for women alike.
You know, one of the other things that I suppose Shonda Rhimes is becoming known for and is now known for is for finding young talent, right?
Yeah.
She even does that with the cast of Bridgerton and now of Queen Charlotte. She takes these sort of previously unknown actors and suddenly it launches their careers.
Yeah.
So the question for you becomes, you know, is this the start of your relationship with Shondaland? Is it the start of much, much bigger things to come? What's next?
I feel like you know something that I don't know. I hope so, right? Because, I mean, my vision has always been on a world class, right? So even in my dreaming, I've always thought, how do I break in pop culture, right? How do I offer orchestra?
Yeah.
Just not just in the theater spaces that we've seen orchestra in. So I would love to do maybe the reimagining of Grey's Anatomy. I don't know.
Oh.
From your lips, at your heartstrings, huh?
From your lips to Shonda's ears.
Definitely, I hope she's listening. Yeah.
Listen, it's wonderful to see you here. Let me ask the team quickly. Do we have a clip that we can play so that we can play out with this, Gary? Do we have it? All right. It's going to have to be that our viewers go on to episode 4.
Mm-hmm.
It's 4 glorious minutes of Ofentse Pitse. I'm going to go and watch it again, and just have
with
a look at you in that
role. With a different perspective.
And maybe I can keep the baton as well.
From the Queen.
From the Queen.
My lady, your grace.
Oh, Ofentse, great to see you.
Thank you.
Many more things to come. We can't wait to see what you do next.
Definitely. Ofentse, thank you so Pitse much.
Is here with us in studio on the AM Report. Go and have a look at Queen Charlotte. Maybe watch it again if you haven't before.